Welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. Today I'm trying to hold a tap in my die stock, and to do that I'm making a collet holder that will fit into the die holder so I could use it in the lathe. I don't know whether it will work, but we'll find out. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it.
This is my guide bar for the die holder, so that goes into the tailstock. The die holder itself has two sides, this side for the larger dies, that side for smaller dies, and I also have an adapter that could go in the large one for even smaller dies on each side.
This was made from a Hemingway kit.
So this goes on there, die in the end, and this will rotate freely until I move the lever to the left or to the right. Then it locks and the die holds still.
I was cutting a thread the other day
and I thought, well, could do something like that for a tap. And I did start to think about using something like this that goes inside there and a tap could go in the hole. And then I realised that different size taps have different size square holes and you need to drill through and put a grub screw in to hold it. So that would mean for every different size tap, you'd need a different ring to hold it. So what I've decided to do is make a part that goes in here that will hold a ER32 collet, which has got all the different sizes. And then I can put the collet holder in here and hold the tap in the collet to see whether it will work. The idea is as you tap in, you push this forward, it locks up and the tap will go in. When you let go, this will just spin round freely. So I've just placed this piece of steel bar in the chuck. I only need about an inch and a half off this end. This is something that was already there before, so I'll take this off. Start from about here and go back. Well, first thing is to see how true that's running. Put my dial indicator in, switch it onto the part. Each division on this dial indicator is a thou. Start it off. Less than 5 thou, so that'd be okay. Set my tool to centre line, so I'll just swing it round on the tool post. Put my gauge on there. Slacken the tool off, lower it down. It goes over the tip of the tool. And as I higher the tool in the holder, as soon as the dial indicator moves, which is just as, that's on height. Put the tool back the other way. Lock it up. Now, to set my compound slide to roughly the right angle, I just take the collet, put a parallel piece of steel in there, touch it on the side of my compound slide, and just check that the edge of this steel is aligned with the edge of the bed. Just a rough guide. That looks okay. I've just put some blue on, put that in and turn it. It should show that in the bolt. You see lines across in the bore, so I think that's the right angle. The next thing to do is check the depth. There's a depth gauge on the end. It's 14.79. And compare that with one that I've been using, 14.9. It's not that far off. What I'll try and do is just get a better finish in the bore. Take the sharp edge off the corner, just making an undercut for the end of the thread. Set the thread cutting tool square to the part I'm making. Now's the time you can check you have the right pitch. Put a collet in there. Turned it round and put the part back in the chuck. Just face this off. That's the finished part, well, nearly finished. All I have to do is add three dimples where the grub screws go. I've tightened the 8mm tap. I've fitted the collet holder in my die stock. and I've drilled a hole in there for an 8mm thread. So now I want to see whether this will work. So if I let go, it turns. I tighten up, it's cutting. Put a bit of oil on the tap. That's going in. It's come out the other side. Stop it. Reverse it. Well, that's threaded that okay. Let's cut the thread there. Right the way through. You can see where the grub screw has marked the tap holder. So what I could do is just machine a small flat on each one of those if it starts to twist. That's the finished part. Collet fits in there. This end fits in the die holder, so I can use this in the lathe.
I'll need to test it on some more taps before I can say it's a success. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was useful, hope it was interesting, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.